Well, we have spent the majority of the morning talking with people who camped out here at City Hall overnight. We had about 150 people taking part in the Sleep Out for Youth Ottawa, but there are some astounding statistics behind homelessness here in our own city. And joining me now to talk a little bit more about them, Dr. Isra Levy, Medical Officer for Public
Health
Ottawa.
Perfect.
How are you?
Very well, very well. Good. Thanks. And thanks for your interest in this issue. It really is, as you say, lots of frightening statistics in a sense, but also very positive story. A lot of people now aware, organizations that seek to address the issue. So we've got about 1,000 youth in Ottawa, more than 60,000 in Canada, who find themselves without regular shelter for one or other reason. Mm-hmm. And obviously, sometimes it's mental health issues or physical health issues that lead to people being homeless or being on the streets or street involved. And obviously being on the street itself has a lot of health impact as well. So we see real health risks that lead to people being on the street, and we see the street life really affecting people for the negative.
Why do you think that there is a general misconception that a lot of people who are homeless suffer from drug addiction?
You know, a lot of people who have mental health issues or challenges with depression, with challenges in their life, unfortunately have to self-medicate. Mm-hmm. And we see especially people on the street have a much, much higher rate of alcohol use, of drug use, injection and other drug use, than other people in the community. I mean, alcohol use, more than a third of people in Ottawa misuse alcohol, but on the streets it's about 90% when we ask people on the street. So I think what people are doing is they're turning to these substances because they don't necessarily have access to the right medication or the right supports. And that's why I think Youth Services Bureau, Operation Go Home, these are really good organizations trying to address those issues.
And apart from the organizations, what are some of the programs that the city has created to help people who may be homeless?
So we have at Public Health itself, we have street health nurses that work with the other agencies, reach out to people on the streets. You know, a lot of people gather in the downtown area. And so we have our nurses essentially getting to know the individuals over time, forming social networks, and making sure, especially when the weather's bad, that they've got links to shelter if they need for bad weather. Mm-hmm. And one of the things, when every 2 years or so we interview people who are street involved, and we try and ascertain what's really happening to them. Street youth, that's 15 to 24, tell us that in the main, organizations like Youth Services Bureau, about 80 to 90% actually use their services in some way. But then we also hear that very few have success in accessing health services. And so the public health nurses really try and get that to them. Sexual health is a big issue on the streets. Mm-hmm. Almost all youth have been sexually active by 15. Okay.
Dr. Lee, thank you very much. I'm sorry that we have to
Not
cut
at
it
all.
There.
Thanks
you
for
can
your
head
interest.
To the website to look at all of the different statistics and counseling programs available.